Welcome to the new normal and welcome to the InfoX 2020. Like everything, we've gone virtual. What to do? But last year was a great one. Take a look at the screen while I'm walking. The award was great. We also had a massive cover shoot where we had these beautiful people, great content creators, come together for a massive cover shoot. And of course, all of them interviewed inside. But this is going to continue. But the awards is something that I'm missing physically, meeting all of them in person. Last year, the award night was one night to remember because they had coming from everywhere. And it was really a big party. We started this thing and we want to continue this. And like everything, this year we'll conduct the awards right here from my screen. And we'll have the top people talk to us. Let's begin our first nomination and let's start the show. Congratulations, Paletta, you have won once again. Of course, you're the latest pick. Do you realize it's been already 1 year that we were, you know, celebrating the awards?
I know, it is so crazy. Time has flown. I remember wearing my favorite yellow suit.
And I have to give you the trophy, and we have a new trophy by which we give on screen. So where is your trophy? Please take it.
Yes! Thank you. This is the coolest, easiest delivery that has happened online.
Super. I have something more. Do you also remember this?
Oh yes! Oh yes, I remember this also.
There you are.
There I am in my white jacket. I remember this also. This was also a really fun shoot.
And your new fashion, congratulations, is getting good reviews.
Khayali Pulao, yes. Thank you. Thank you so much.
You know, you play a lot of characters in different roles. So you can tell me which character resonates with what I'm going to say. You can also pick any influencer or celebrity if you feel like.
I do this character called Sonia. I think she is more than dramatic.
Do you want to resonate with some content creator or celebrity?
Who is dramatic?
Of course you.
I think Ranveer is also very dramatic. Huh? Like Ranveer, Bare Biceps is super dramatic. I will get afraid. I can't watch horror movies at all. I can't stand them. But with me, who will get afraid? Yeah, everybody watches horror movies. Like everyone from a Nick to an Ashish to a Bone, they're always like, did you watch this? Did you watch that? And I'm like, no, I can't. I have seen Bhuvan spending so much money on full chatak sneakers and jackets. Laugh at the wrong moment, Nick, for sure.
Yeah.
You, Nick, for sure. He will laugh, he'll crack a joke, and he'll go and tell everybody else that he did it. It's always nice to feel like someone's watching you and someone's liking what you're doing and appreciating. It's a massive pat on my back. I appreciate that.
And since I was meeting you, I got all the tech toys in front of me. It's a Leo bhai Gaurav aare saath mein.
क्या बात है, अगर मुझे पता होता तो मैं भी अपना पूरा कलेक्शन सामने लेके बैठता।
क्या दुनिया को बताए, जरूरत नहीं उसका भी। गौरव, many congratulations, of course, you could have the trophy. You deserve every inch and bit of it. So, you know, all your fans, and we want to know how it all started. Like, what was the first thought which came to you, which triggered all this, you know?
After my studies was done, like my master's was done, I had option to go for a PhD or then MBA. Yeah, मतलब ठीक है ना, पढ़ाई हो गई, अभी life में आगे कुछ और करना है. तो उस time पे ये हुआ कि all the friends are gone. अभी जो आपके school college के दोस्त हैं, वो निकल गए हैं, सब अपनी life में कुछ ना कुछ कर रहे हैं. तो I think that was the time wherein I felt कि okay, it's a time to develop a new hobby. And hobby क्या हो सकता है? तो चलो यार, why not myself, you know, create videos and tech के बारे में videos बनाते हैं. तो वो सोच के फिर 2015 में स्टार्ट किया. मतलब सुबह से उठा, एक वीडियो बनाया, मोबाइल पे अपना रिकॉर्ड किया, ऑन द गो निकला हूं, तो गाड़ी में ऑफिस पहुंचते पहुंचते पीछे एडिट कर लिया, और ऑफिस पहुंच के जो मौका मिला था पोस्ट कर दिया. इट हैज बीन द रूटीन, एंड इवन टुडे इट इज द रूटीन.
सो नाउ व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट ड्रीम गैजेट यू बॉट, गौरव?
तो जब मैं थर्ड स्टैंडर्ड में था, तो उस टाइम पे माय डैड गिव मी द फर्स्ट कंप्यूटर, एंड आई थिंक उसमें कुछ उस टाइम पे 4.5 GB की हार्ड ड्राइव थी और 32 MB की रैम थी. और वो नीचे जो सीपीयू रखते थे ना, ऊपर जिसके मोटर होता था पुराने वाला.
डेवलप अ ड्रीम गैजेट, मतलब आपको कुछ बनाना हो जो तुम यू फील दैट अभी कोई बना नहीं रहा, मतलब यू समथिंग दैट इज अ
आई थिंक समथिंग टू क्रिएट मल्टीपल वर्जंस ऑफ माय सेल्फ, और मैं वर्चुअली कहीं भी प्रेजेंट हो जाऊं एक साथ.
यू नो इंस्टाग्राम इज माइंड ब्लोइंग विद ऑल द ब्यूटीफुल कार्स. व्हिच कार डू यू ओन एक्चुअली? ऑल ऑफ देम और व्हाट इज इट?
So whatever you see on Instagram, those are all my personal cars.
Oh my god!
Personally, I drive a Panamera. मुझे पसंद है और अदरवाइज आई लाइक द जी वैगन एज वेल. अभी रोल्स रॉयस किया था तो वो भी उसका एक अलग ही मतलब वो है.
गौरव, इट वाज लवली टॉकिंग टू यू. अमेजिंग टाइम. कांग्रेचुलेशंस गौरव फॉर ब्रेकिंग ऑल द रिकॉर्ड्स. यू आर आल्सो आवर हेल्थ एंड फिटनेस इन्फ्लुएंसर ऑफ द ईयर. ऑफ कोर्स नोबडी एल्स देन यू. योर नेम रेजोनेट्स विद यू लाइक बीस्ट. सो हाउ डज इट फील नाउ विद योर YouTube चैनल नाउ विद 1 मिलियन हिट्स? फिनोमिनल गौरव.
Thank you so much. Feels amazing. I mean, I remember the last year we were all gathered in Mumbai. We had a great time. Correct. Unfortunately, I was hoping ki, you know, by the time we have the announcement for the awards, everything will be fine and life will be back a little bit usual. But okay, not normal time. So yeah, but feeling great and thank you so much to Exhibit.
So tell us something about your journey. I mean, how it has changed, you know, as a person, because of late, Gaurav, you've gone through a lot of things, you know. Of course, going up against big brands is not easy, it doesn't come easy, it comes as a cost, personal cost as your career, etc. You've taken a lot. So does it make you a better person or does it firm you even more to resonate with, you know, whatever is being said and whatever is being done?
So this has made me learn a lot. This has made me very strong from inside, because when it all started, we had this inhibition ki, you know, क्या होगा, वी आर नथिंग कंपेयर्ड टू देम एंड वी आर जस्ट इंडिविजुअल्स. बट देन आई लर्नड अ लॉट फ्रॉम लॉट ऑफ पीपल अराउंड मी एंड स्पेशली लाइक समवन टोल्ड मी कि अगर आप बस आपको एक क्वालिटी चाहिए, इफ यू आर गोइंग अगेंस्ट सच बिग जायंट एंड इफ यू नो यू आर राइट, एक क्वालिटी चाहिए आपको, आपको निडर होना पड़ेगा.
सक्सेस इज अ रेंटेड प्लेस, यू नो, एंड यू हैव टू पे रेंट एवरी डे.
सो यस यस, सो
यू हैव टू वर्क हार्ड एवरी डे.
कैसा जा रहा है, बॉडी कैसा रिस्पॉन्ड कर रही है, सुबह उठ के वर्कआउट करने का मन कर रहा है कि नहीं कर रहा, भूख कितनी लग रही है, वो सब चीजों से मैं, क्योंकि हमने जब स्टार्ट किया तो ये सब चीजें थी, फिटनेस ऐप्स होती नहीं, तो आई जस्ट गो बाय दैट.
गौरव, ग्रेट टॉकिंग टू यू.
Thank you so much for giving me this, the health and fitness influencer.
Congrats, Nikhil. You are the trendsetter of the year. Before we begin, let me
give you
a trophy. Here's a trophy for you. I hope you got it.
Thank you. Thank you so much for this.
Hold on one now.
Yes.
Your content always makes people so connected. You know, you do so, your vlogs are so like real.
See, for me, when I make videos, it is a passion. I was always a guy who loves camera, to face camera, to do something. And when the audience is appreciating my work, so that's what keeps me going, that there are people who are waiting for a video. There are people who are waiting to see ki aaj Nikhil ka din kis tarah gaya, kaisa gaya.
So, weirdest experience you ever had while traveling?
I'll tell you a very weird experience. I was in Aurangabad. हुआ क्या, वहाँ पे बहुत सारे लोग मिलने आ रहे थे एंड आई थॉट आई डोंट हैव मेनी सब्सक्राइबर्स ओवर देयर, तो बहुत सारे लोग मिलने आ रहे हैं और मैं फोटो खिंचा रहा हूँ, 1000 तक फोटो खिंचा ली. नाउ आई आल्सो वांट टू गो आउट, तो मैं गाड़ी लेके निकला और सब कुछ बाइक लेके आ रहे हैं, तो मैं चलो कुछ अभी क्या करूँ, तो मैं एयरपोर्ट के अंदर घुस गया. अब मुझे पता एयरपोर्ट के अंदर बाइक अलाउड नहीं है, मैं एयरपोर्ट के अंदर घुसा और जहाँ से घुसा वहीं से निकलने जा रहा था, तो मुझे कॉप्स ने रोका मुझे, यू कांट एग्जिट दिस प्लेस. सो आई टोल्ड देम see actually a lot of my fans are following me. अरे सर आपको मैंने वो पिक्चर में देखा है, like exactly मैं वही हूँ, तो मुझे प्लीज आते जाना है.
What works more for you, Instagram or YouTube?
I think both is in their own position, both works well for me, but I am more into YouTube. Like I enjoy making YouTube video content, so I would say that YouTube works more for me.
Great Nikhil, it was great talking to you. Keep doing what you're doing. We always look forward and see you very soon. Congratulations, Sejal, for winning the Fashion Influencer of the Year award back in 2020. Let me complete, because this was one of the most coveted titles, because it was a big race and there were a lot of people. You were a step ahead of all of them, and it's basically completely on voting. So, you know, what's your first thing that comes to your mind? Tell me.
I was very surprised actually, because I saw the page once and I sent it to my family group and my friends group. They were like, whatever. कर लेंगे तेरे लिए वोट. And then I kind of, you know, let it be. Ki theek hai, ab dekha jayega. And then suddenly I get this, you know, news, and I was so shocked. I was like, what? But that's so cool. I'm so happy.
Whenever I met you, you have been very casual about your clothes and everything. But do you really dress up like, or what?
No, so I think that's what is my kind of, I think people relate with me because of that also, because I'm very chill in my style and I'm very open about it. So of course I love to dress up, I'm that girl, I'll wear my pink blazer whenever, but you will see me in chappals also all the time, and I'm very confident in that way. So maine apna USP waise bana diya hai, elevated casual. So I think that's my,
you're always carrying your confidence with you. That's more important than the clothes, right? So what's your take on sustainable fashion? With, like, the world is talking sustainable. What's your take?
It's the need of the hour. And I mean, I know it's really difficult for young college students and young people to get into it because it's expensive. It's an expensive way of life. And even for me, and it's a huge change. But slowly and slowly, you know, I'm also discovering more Indian local brands every day. So trying to shift my consumption there, and also not buying so much, buying one thing, wearing it for longer. So that's small ways I'm also trying to get into that lifestyle.
Has it ever been that you've, you know, posted something and you've got some weirdest of comments and it really makes you laugh and angry at the same time? You know, happens, right?
Yeah, all the time. In fact, today only I get it in my emails. Emails make me laugh the most, because today I got an email, subject line, cutie Sejal, and in the body it was written, Sejal, aap stories pe kyun nahi post karte ho? Please post kya karo. So maine screenshot karke bhej diya apne friends ko. all that kind of stuff is pretty funny. The newest thing, these sick sneakers. Absolutely love them. They're from Reebok, and I love so much. This is my new baby, my camera.
Oh wow!
Oh my god! Yeah, this is the Fujifilm X-T4, and if anyone comes near this, I will kill them. This one. This is gem jewelry, very basic, but it's an old one from this place called Dilli Haat in Delhi. It's a really nice market.
Once again, congratulations. And before I go, I'm going to give you the trophy which is lying here. Because it's pandemic time, I'm going to give you virtually. Please catch it.
Thank you. This is absolutely lovely, and I'm so happy. Like I said, such a shock and so happy. Thank you. Thank you for this.
Congrats, Namrata, for winning the Entrepreneur Influencer of the Year. And I've personally known you for 7-8 years, I don't even know how long do I know you. And I've seen you go through the curve completely, from starting a new gym to now, talk of the town, everybody wants to be a piece of you.
No, first of all, thank you so much, because, you know, this one is really special because it says Entrepreneur Influencer, which is really special because you're also recognizing the fact that I do run studios and have a business which is very close to my heart, which is something I started. Well, now it's been over 10 years. You've been a part of my journey, kind of. And when we started 10 years ago, we started, you know, with Dad's back office. So it was Dad's back office, and we just converted one little room of his into a private studio, and we started training a few people there. And then from that, over the years, I think we started expanding little by little by little. And only in the last 3-4 years have we really gone all over the country. I was told that I'm going to have to stop horse riding, dancing, playing squash and all the things I enjoy. But that's when my dad was hosting a Pilates course in Bombay. He had called down some instructors from Canada, and he was hosting a course, and I like begged to be on the course. I was like, let me try it out, and, you know, only give me the certificate if I pass the exam. If I don't, anyway, I don't. Like, let me at least try. What's the big deal? So anyway, so I tried it out, and within 3 or 4 sessions, I was absolutely pain-free for the first time in an entire year. So that's how I became a real believer of the form of exercise.
What are the 3 things that you can overeat?
I could really binge on spaghetti aglio olio. I absolutely love spaghetti aglio olio. I don't know when to stop. I think another thing that I can overeat is popcorn, like, especially in a movie. If I'm watching a movie, I can like keep going at it. And what else? Oh, I what else can? Maybe cheesecake, but I don't think I can overeat it, but I do enjoy like binging on it once in a while.
What's your favorite workout playlist? Do you have a playlist or do you listen to audiobooks? What is it?
My favorite workout playlist? Oh, when I'm going crazy, like really working out hard, I love Psy Trance. I can go crazy on psychedelic trance. Otherwise, I'm doing deep house, tropical house.
Great, Namrata, great talking to you. It's a pleasure to give you this trophy right now because I have known you personally and I know the journey that you've been through. Wish you all the best.
Yes.
Planning. Congratulations, Larissa. Great to have you back. You are the travel influencer of the year. How have you been doing? How has been the lockdown affected you? Because I'm sure for travel influencer category, you must be really craving to go out and do your content. So how's it going?
Thank you so much for giving me this award. It feels great. And when the nominations were given out, I was excited even then. And to actually get the award, it feels great at the moment. That's right. I agree. The pandemic has hit us in a very funny way, actually, especially the travel industry. I do feel like traveling and making content, but it's safe for us to not do that at the moment.
Do you go to some place for inspiration or are you just on the go?
I mean, it's always on the go. I try to keep it as impromptu as possible. The more you plan, the more anxious I feel. And I don't really like planning, especially when I'm shooting. I like it to be very, very impromptu. And even like there's no scripting at all. I just speak whatever comes to my mind about the place. Yeah, it's all about the experience and what you feel about the whole situation when you're there.
What are the top three things on your mind when you choose a travel destination?
The locals, the culture. I think these are the top two things. Also the language.
So when the pandemic is over, which is the first place that you'll actually go to?
I really wanted to do Italy this summer, but it couldn't happen.
Will you consider traveling on a solo trip or have you been there?
I have tried solo traveling. In fact, when I went to Paris, it was like a solo trip. So I went there for work and then I extended my trip. So it was a solo trip. And I didn't really enjoy it that much. I enjoy having at least one person because I'm a person who talks a lot. I like to share my experiences. So I like having someone with me who I can speak to, where you know, you can tell them, oh, look at that. Oh, the food is good.
Weirdest thing I've ever eaten in a trip.
So I've eaten a scorpion. I have eaten a cockroach. I have eaten a snake.
Oh God, seriously?
I've also eaten a crocodile.
So what is your most exotic international destination you've been to? Like, not mainstream?
Exotic? I think I've been to Maldives.
Larissa, it was great chatting up with you. Amazing time.
Thanks.
This trophy is on your way, but it'll reach you very soon. And enjoy your stay in Goa. Until we meet again, cheers and take care. Congratulations, Anis. Great to have you with us. It's a new
Thank role. You so much for having me once again. I'm so excited today.
When you plan content, how do you know that it will go viral or you just are very natural? Whatever you do, you just do naturally. Is that the trick?
Oh, see, for me, I have been learning all these years. And if I have to come to a point where I've reached today and understand my content better, I feel that being raw and being real with your audience helps to establish a connection with them. So yeah, I never plan in my head. It's always my day because I make vlogs. So it's always natural what's happening in my life. And yeah, that's what I share.
So when you edit it, do you have a lot of cuts or you just go with the flow?
Because it's my life and because I want to put the real thing out, there's not many cuts. So I get done in say half an hour and something if I want to add some music or something. But yeah, it's pretty easy for me to edit vlogs. In my bag, I think the first thing is my camera, has to be there. Then it's my laptop. And that's pretty much everything I need because camera to, shoot everything and make memories and laptop to edit it ASAP and put it online for the world to watch it. I have this one comb which is like it has this static force when you keep it out, so it acts and it styles your hair very nicely. So that is something my friends find weird because they're like, "Tu itna tamjham leke aati hai."
Keep doing what you're doing, Ganesh. We're so proud to have you with us. Congrats, Ashad. You won the Social Media Personality of the Year. Great to have you with us back again. You know, of course, this is the new normal, so we are doing it like this. First of all, let me give you the trophy which you deserve. Kindly, please take it and extend my fullest thanks to you.
Oh, yay! This is so cool.
Now, Ashad, you know, during the lockdown, what thoughts came to your mind? Like, what kept you alive to create content? Because it must be a very big challenge, right?
I was a person who always used to be out. Like, my mom used to always complain ki tum ghar pe nahi rehti ho and stuff. But when this happened, I was obviously really, I was dreaded to my soul. I was really, because it's something that I've never experienced and I never thought this would happen. But I think at the same time, I also got a lot of time for myself. I was at home, I was reading, I was watching a lot of stuff, I was spending time with my family. So I think that was a little bit of a benefit, and I think eventually things have started. This is the new normal. Everybody's taking precautions. I started shooting.
Now what does ma'am mom say? Ki bahar kab jaoge?
No, she's still very scared. She doesn't want me to go and get out of the house at all. Matlab wo to khush hai ki main ghar pe hu, to unko koi problem nahi. Instagram is one, definitely. I think WhatsApp, because all my work happens on WhatsApp. So WhatsApp. This is my birthday was on the 5th, and I clicked like a lot of Polaroid pictures. So that's my mom. That's my friend.
Congratulations once again.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Congratulations, Abhi, on you and crossing 1 million mark, and you are the change maker in Prince of the Year. These difficult times, how have you been? Like, how has the lockdown been with you? What have you guys been doing?
A lot of work, a lot of videos, and also the stuff that we wouldn't do otherwise, like cleaning up the house, washing the vessels. Now I'm slowly becoming an expert in washing vessels.
So before you started this channel, you know, what triggered this whole thought? Like, when did you decide, okay, let me step this up?
It was during last year in 2019. And I thought that there was something lacking. I wanted to make videos about the things I actually care about. So that's how the idea of 100 Reasons to Love India came together. So that was the idea.
Wow. So basically, one reason why we focus on making positive videos or working on change is because we feel that our feeds are very negative. You get a lot of negative information everywhere around you. And that's just the way your brain works. You are more attracted to the negative first. You click on a negative title before you click on a positive title.
Like, what are the real challenges that you overcome, you know?
Lots of challenges. Firstly, figuring out which topic to make a video about, getting some sort of objectivity in that topic so that it's not just an opinion piece but something that people can get value out of. So that is the biggest challenge, that finding content, and it's a common challenge for every content creator out there, no matter what he does. So that's the biggest challenge. Seema aunty, Desi Tinder, that's
yeah,
what came to my mind.
Work.
I think Jio is going to buy TikTok.
Data theft. Excitement.
Long shot. I mean, I don't remember how travel feels like. Like, travel for us is going from here to the kitchen.
Great talking to you guys. And before I go, there is this award for you. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Let's pose for a photo.
Hi guys, this is Amit Saraf from Digitech, your technology partner for the Influencex 2.0 presented by The Exhibit magazine. A lot of you may already know that Digitech has the right technology and the accessories to create app videos to influence a lot many people. We request you to try some of them.
Congratulations, Ujwal. You are the Gamer Influencer of the Year. Of course, it's a great feeling.
Thank you so much. It is because of your love and support.
Ujwal, how did you all start? Like, when was the starting? When did you know that you have a gamer in you and
मैंने कुछ वीडियोस पहले डाल दी थी ऐसी मजे के लिए मैं दूसरों की देखता तो मैंने भी डाल दी थी तो काफी टाइम बाद ना उस पर अच्छे खासे व्यूज आ गए वो मेरे को पता ही नहीं था उस पर व्यूज आ गए हैं, तो मेरे भाई ने देखा तो उसने फिर बोला कि तू कंटिन्यू कर इस चीज को।
गेमिंग इज अ फुल टाइम प्रोफेशन, वेरी सीरियस प्रोफेशन, इट रिक्वायर्स अ लॉट ऑफ स्किल्स। ऐसा नहीं है कि बैठ के आदमी गेमिंग कर रहा है, इसमें टू मच वर्क इज देयर।
पहले चलता था मारियो चलता था,
करेक्ट,
तो उस टाइम पर वो मैंने, हां वो तो सब का ही बस गेम होगा।
यू आर वेरी पॉपुलर ऑफ कोर्स ऑन यूट्यूब एज अ गेमर, यू आर गेमिंग इन्फ्लुएंसर, बट व्हिच गेमर डू यू लुक अप टू, मतलब कौन सा, मतलब हु इंस्पायर्स यू,
जेली माइनक्राफ्ट ये सब गेम्स खेलते थे, पर उस टाइम पर इतना अच्छा पीसी नहीं था कि ये गेम्स चल जाए, तो मैंने मोबाइल से स्टार्ट करा, बट अब मैं पीसी गेम्स पर स्विच हो गया लास्ट ईयर। चाइल्डहुड फेवरेट गेम्स स्नो ब्रोस मारियो एंड थर्ड इज कॉन्ट्रा, वही है अब जो यही चलता है, वो शीट साले अबे कहाँ जा रहा है ये वो, इसके बिना तो मजा ही नहीं है बाकी।
GTA 5 और Fortnite?
GTA 5.
Minecraft or PUBG?
Minecraft.
I have to give you the trophy which you rightly deserve. Here's the trophy, please accept it. This is what you deserve.
Thank you, thank you.
Congratulations, Mrunal. Great to have you with us. And you are our top 10 influencer. And before we begin, let me first give you the trophy. There is a trophy.
Oh, woohoo! Thank you so much.
But ek baat batao, how did you keep yourself motivated during the entire lockdown period?
Ups and downs to aate hain kafi. Ki matlab ek point tha ki mujhe jab acha nahi lag raha tha ki kuch banane ke liye, but वही एक मेरा मोटिवेशन था, क्योंकि लोग बोलते थे कि हम आपकी वीडियोस देख के मोटिवेट होते हैं, हमें खुशी मिलती है, तो आप वो करते रहो, तो उनके वजह से ही मैं पोस्ट करती हूँ एंड उनको मतलब फुल खुश रखा लॉकडाउन के टाइम में पूरा।
अगर आपको एक चांस मिले किसी ब्यूटी गुरु के साथ में कोलैबोरेट करने का, who would that be?
जेफ्री स्टार और जेम्स चार्ल्स, मतलब ये दोनों में से एक। और डियोर फाउंडेशन बहुत एक्सपेंसिव था, बट स्टिल आई गॉट इट। आई थिंक ये पैलेट होगा, ये मैंने बहुत यूज किया है लिटरली।
थैंक्स फॉर जॉइनिंग अस, इट वाज ग्रेट टू हैव यू मृणाल, ऑल द बेस्ट, कीप डूइंग व्हाट यू आर डूइंग। सो नेक्स्ट अप इज आवर फूड इन्फ्लुएंसर ऑफ द ईयर एंड वी हैव रौनक विद अस। रौनक, कांग्रेचुलेशंस, यू आर द रीजन व्हाई आई हैव नेवर लॉस्ट वेट, बिकॉज आई पुट ऑन वेट सीइंग योर फीड्स। So tell us, how do you do it? How do you do it all the time?
Oh man, good. So we've been running Mumbai Foodie for the last 6.5 years now almost.
Right.
So I have personally gone through 6.5 years, yeah. So I've personally gone through various weight changes, body changes constantly, you know. So yeah.
One thing, Ronak, I really liked about your feed is that there is no mention of you. There's no picture of you. You only stick to your core, you only talk about food. I mean, never you felt the need, okay, let me put some pictures that the people know who I am, man behind it. Not many people know that you are the man behind it also, right?
I mean, yeah, I mean, now people, I think, have become aware about the fact that it's me behind it and I'm the one who started it. But, you know, Mumbai Foodie is more of a, it's more of a team effort than just me.
So what are your three top favorite dishes?
As cliche as it may sound, I love the butter chicken.
Okay.
Like, there's no two ways about that. I love getting a butter vada pav on the road. If you want to say gourmet, then I love the ramen that you get in Bombay now.
Okay. What have you been experimenting in the kitchen of late?
My only presence in the kitchen is while I'm making myself a great cup of coffee. That's it.
Before we end this conversation, it was lovely talking to you. Already feel like eating some lot of stuff, and there's the trophy. You're the winner and you rightly deserve it. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, guys.
Congratulations. So congrats Lakshya. Congrats Lakshya for being the Born to Ride Influencer of the Year. How did you start? Like, how has the journey been?
2016 mein maine socha tha ki moto vlogging karenge. तो तब पेरेंट्स ने बाइक तो दिलाई नहीं, तब मेरे पास स्कूटी थी TVS की, तो मैंने कहा अब जरूरी थोड़ी है कि बाइक होगी तभी मोटर व्लॉगिंग होगी। तो मैं बाइक स्कूटी लेके पहले मैंने बॉम्बे की राइड करी, दिल्ली टू बॉम्बे, और कॉन्टिन्यूसली मैंने राइड करा था, हाँ, दिल्ली टू बॉम्बे और TVS जुपिटर 100 cc।
अरे वाह। चल टेल मी समथिंग लक्ष्य, What is the dumbest way you've ever got injured?
अभी recently February के अंदर मैं स्पीति जा रहा था अपने हिमालयन के ऊपर 20-25 मीटर स्किट होके ब्लैक आइस के ऊपर सीधा रोड पे स्किट करके जा रहा हूँ और एक नहीं दो बार हुआ मैं उठा फिर मैंने राइड करनी चालू करी 5 मिनट बाद फिर गिर गया
Congratulations, wish you all the best, keep doing, keep riding high. Congratulations, Madan, you are the breakthrough talent of the year. Your Instagram post has been really filled with great social issues. Keep up good work. Many, many congratulations. Let me start this session by giving you the trophy, which is rightfully yours.
Thanks, man. Thanks a lot.
So how's been going? How has been the lockdown? Tell me how things with you.
Everything has changed in the lockdown. You know, the world as we know it has been on pause and it's a new world now. So yeah, adapting to the changes and pushing the limits often.
Tell me something, what was the first incident that made you, think about speaking about the social issues? The first incident?
The first one is that there was a murder of a girl that happened in Chennai in a railway station, you know, in the early morning. And there were so many people around her and not really many tried to stop that particular murder. So it was more of an angst. So one day I just realized that I can post it on the internet so that someone who is like me in some corner of the world might resonate with the same thought. So I posted it and I claim that a lot of people resonate with the same idea.
Your audience will be very curious to know about what Madan Gauri's phones look like. So we'll play a game called What's On Your Phone.
We set alarms every day. There are like 5 or 6 alarms. I set alarm for everything. So even for this event, right, I set an alarm. So everything is an alarm. I have tried and I have not been successful.
Thank you so much, Madan. Thank you so much for your time. And once again, many congratulations. That's it, guys. What a long day, but what an amazing day. When do you get to interact with such great content creators in one day? Second edition of InfoX, all gone virtual, thanks to the environment that we are in. I couldn't believe that after the first great event, where we had a ball of a time, all of them had a great time. We're doing things like this, but I guess that's the normal. This is the curated version. We have in-depth conversations dropping to our channel very soon. So for that, subscribe to the channel. And I promise you for the next edition, which is the InfoX 2021, we'll have a great party. And by that time, things will also be normal. Until then, stay safe. I'm taking the awards. I'll bring it back next year again.